every place has a story, and we are here today to tell you the story of Monterano and discover its history and mystery. This place has been populated for thousands of years before it met its final demise. And these prehistoric civilizations advanced through the Bronze Age, the Iron Age, to the advanced yet highly mysterious indigenous civilization known as the Etruscans.
Inside the building, I'm seeing a starburst. Boy, is it bright, yellowish light coming through. But
something was there centuries ago that let the light in.
I'm hearing echoes, but they're all muffled. I don't feel catacombs, but that doesn't mean that there aren't any, or tunnels.
There are some underground places I want to show you, making it an ideal stone to carve out room-sized tombs for the dead.
Was this an area where prisoners were once kept or held? It seems like I feel people waiting. I feel their anxiousness that they want to get out.
Why would there not be enough people in Monterano to make use of the local prison in late 1770s? Well, 1770 marked the beginning of the end of a settlement that has been in existence here for thousands of years. In 1776, a far more serious scourge befell Monterano, malaria. The mosquito-borne infectious disease, its once vibrant population was reduced to just a few dozen villagers. The etymology of malaria derives from the Italian medieval term for bad air, due to the belief that the disease was caused by the stench coming from the wetlands. And the climate of Monterano is one that it's been quite humid, of course, a perfect breeding ground for malaria. Incidentally, the first doctor to connect malaria to mosquitoes was an Italian physician from Rome, Giovanni Maria Lancisi, born in 1654. Obviously, with the population dwindling to just a few dozen, the local prison fell in disuse and in disrepair. But this was not the end of Monterano, though. The final blow has yet to come. And it amounted to one simple decision, a decision that sealed the fate of Monterano and its inhabitants forever. Late 1770s saw the invasion of Napoleon's French army into Italy. In February 1798, Napoleon's army invaded Rome and took control of the Papal States, declaring them the Roman Republic, a client republic under the French Directory. Pope Pius VI was exiled to France, where he died soon after. Rome had no pope. This control was short-lived, as the Papal States were restored a year later, after the Naples army intervened. However, what happened during this short period of the French occupation changed everything. The French controlled this region, including the neighborhood village of Tolfa. Following a bloody insurgency against the French, the Tolfetani found themselves without a grinding wheel to grind their grains to feed their people, which by now also included the French army. So they came to ask the Monterano villagers if they can help. The Monteranesi, trying to maintain a neutral position in fear of retaliation by those who were against the French, refused to help the Tolfetani. This decision and their underestimation of the French proved lethal. The Tolfetani returned home and reported the refusal to the French commander. The French, feeling entitled to their daily bread, ordered the Tolfetani to return to Monterano, but this time with military escort. The Monteranesi, seeing the Tolfetani approaching with the French army beside them, quickly fled the village and went into hiding. When the French army penetrated the city walls, they found nobody there. But nonetheless, the French retaliated with unprecedented force, destroying everything in sight, and setting fire to the village. After the troops had left, the Monteranesi returned to assess the damage done to their village and their homes. The damage was beyond repair, at least not at a huge expense that the villagers could not sustain. And thus, Monterano was abandoned as inhabitants salvaged whatever they could from doors and roofs and furnishings necessary to rebuild, and they moved to nearby towns of Canale and Monte Virginio, leaving behind a ruined village and two reluctant friars who did not want to abandon the San Bonaventura convent. The friars' desperate pleas for the Altieri family to restore the village failed, and so they too were forced to leave the convent in year 1800. From here on, Monterano became an abandoned ghost town.
Has there been documentaries created here? I feel like people were here with cameras, relaying the history, taking videos and pictures that are interspersed. I know that probably this place has been filmed a million times. It feels like it. But it seems like something very special was filmed here. Like after further information was discovered about this place, and then it was refilmed.
Monterano may have been lost, but not forgotten. Surprisingly, over 100 films were shot here since the 1950s, and requests continue to be placed with the management of the reserve. Among the most notable movies filmed here was the 1959 Ben-Hur with a scene filmed by the river, and the Italian all-time favorite, The Marquis of Grillo. Documentaries too have been filmed here, mostly in Italian. Festivals also take place here, such as the Living Nativities around Christmas time. Living Nativities are historical reenactments from various eras, from biblical times to medieval and Renaissance periods, with the central theme being the Nativity. They are quite popular in Italy. What would a ghost town be without ghosts?
If this is a tourist area, the spirits are just not happy that the tourists come to visit. In fact, they get really irritated when the gates open, and they go and hide in a place where the tourists cannot come and visit. And then they feel real happy when the tourists leave and the gates are closed, then they can enjoy their own spaces.
The ghost town of Monterano, as well as the natural reserve, are continuously visited by thousands of tourists and locals who wish to visit the ancient town, as well as hike or bike through the natural reserve. You'll find more visitor information on the A Road We Traveled website. To enter the park, you'll find two sets of gates, a large double-door iron gate for vehicles to pass through and a small wooden gate to the side for the average pedestrian use. Unfortunately for us, there are some areas of the ghost town that are not accessible to the public, such as the inside of the Church of San Bonaventura, which is quartered off and can only be viewed from outside the doorway, and the Ducal Palace, which does not permit visitors to climb up the side stairway or enter in any way. Even the small church of San Rocco is corded off. I wonder if the spirits that Sandy mentioned are hiding inside these ruins. Possibly a great place for any ghost hunters out there? This marks the end of Sandy's remote visit, as well as our physical visit to the ghost town of Monterano. I think I was able to pretty much identify all the places that Sandy saw metaphysically in her remote visit, and I found documentation for the places and objects that are not possible to physically visit or are no longer around. It's been a very interesting journey through this evocative ghost town and through its extensive and fascinating history. Come and visit Monterano for yourself. Put on your comfy shoes and immerse yourself in a journey through time. 3,000 years of history belonging to the ghost town of Monterano alone, and much more belonging to this extraordinary landscape with volcanic beginnings that shape this dramatic panorama of undulating hills, wide river valleys, canyons, and lush vegetation. Monterano waits for you to come and visit for yourself. For more information on Monterano and the Natural Reserve, log on www.aroadthroughtraveled.com. See you next time on Psychic Archaeology and on the Road Through Traveled for more of Italy. After all, there's a wealth of history and mystery waiting to be explored. What are living nativities? In the special bonus segment of this episode on the Aurora Traveled app, you will learn more about living nativities in Italy and how you can experience them for yourself. As a special bonus, you'll find my list of favorite places in central Italy where living nativities are held each year between Christmas and Epiphany, as well as a fun video with original footage from various living nativities reenacting historical events from biblical times to the Renaissance era. This video is available only on the Road Through Traveled app. As an added bonus, everyone who downloads the Road Through Traveled app will find a special code associated with this documentary, good for a 50 euro coupon towards any full-day tour with one of Rome's leading tour companies, Stefano Rome Tours, so you can experience the ghost town of Monterano and other fascinating Etruscan places for yourself. You can log on Stefano Rome Tours' website for more tour ideas and inspirations. You can download your own Road Through Traveled app from the iTunes store for just $1.99. Visit the Road Through Traveled website to find out what other fun bonuses are available on the travel app associated with this and all previous episodes of the Ghost Town of Monterano documentary. Thank you for watching.